To round six of the Three Wide Racing Nathan Young Designs B Car Series. Our stop here on round six will be Charlotte Motor Speedway, 120 laps tonight. Alongside me is my partner Race Clark.
How you doing? Glad to be back.
So a little bit of a change here tonight. They're going to be qualifying. Well, they're qualifying now, actually. They're going to be qualifying for about 5 minutes. Not sure about the drivers' meeting tonight. I don't think there might be one because Tanner Sharp will not be in the field tonight. So we'll have 5 minutes to qualify, two laps to do it, and then we'll go racing here tonight.
Yeah, I think we spoke with Carlos. He said that only real qualifying experience is towards the end of the run. It's looking like a fuel run will be about 25 to 30 laps. So I'd say with the way Charlotte is, it's definitely going to be a competitive race, especially being nice tracks that are cooler. We have fixed setups, it's always keep us close, so I'm really excited to see how this one goes. We have qualifying underway right now. At the top of the board is, Jeff Story, 28.6, so it's only a few qualifiers. It's going to change very rapidly.
And one thing to note tonight as well, after talking to some of the drivers in the field tonight, they say the car has been very stable throughout the run, and really doesn't lose speed until the end of the run, so... they said, should there be a caution, it would be guys maybe driving over their head. So that's good to hear, because we've had some interesting races these past couple weeks. Right now we're going to be watching our driver, Johnny Thomas. He's going to be our in-race reporter, and as soon as he climbs out of that car, we're going to get a chance to talk to him. Top of the board right now is Richard Garcia. Wade Lear just hopped into second. Jeff Story is third. As you can see, Johnny Thomas is currently slotted in fourth, but still got some time to go here.
Pretty close lap times. I mean, from first, it looks like 12th. I mean, we're separated by like a tenth and a half. So, I mean, as always, with a fixed setup and a grippy track, you're going to have a lot of close competition tonight. So let's hope. That's not going to breed any problems. We'll see. Charlotte's not really known for a caution fest, but I mean, you never really know. We'll see.
Just getting on the top of the board, Richard Garcia and Johnny Thomas just slowly but surely going to make his way down pit road. Not sure if there's too many people left qualifying here. I think Paul Ross may still be on a run. Nope, he's gonna pull it in. So, with Johnny sitting there now, we're gonna take this chance to bring him in up into the booth. Johnny, you got us, man?
Johnny boy.
I got you loud and clear.
Qualified fourth, why not first?
Well, the driver's not good enough.
That's all for Johnny Thomas. No, I'm just playing. So, I mean, what's the game plan tonight? Are we getting up front, leading some laps, trying to get in that clean air, or are you trying to stay out of trouble and see what you got at the end? What's the game plan?
Man, I'm trying to stay out of trouble. You know what? The tires seem to be wearing off a whole bunch.
So, really?
Yeah. After about 6-7 laps, I'm down about 6/10 of a second.
Oh, that's really interesting to hear.
Yeah.
Because I know we've heard it. It's been all around the board, so I guess we'll see how that factors in. I know we spoke with Carlos. He says... I think what Carlos said is it doesn't really get loose until the end of the run, so I don't think he really meant, I think he meant it's just drivable until the end of the run, so I guess we shall see.
I'm fighting a tight condition too, and I think because I'm driving too hard first couple laps, but we'll see what happens. I don't know. I think we'll be alright. Tires are going to wear out, so I think a fuel strategy is about, fuel runs about 27, 28 laps.
Alright.
So these cars are going to be fun to drive.
All right, well, I'm excited to see what you do, and we'll be talking to you later.
Hopefully we can get that Carhartt Camaro Chevy in victory lane.
Yes, sir. Too bad I'm not there to whoop your ass. Peace out, Chris Gown.
That's right.
All right, that was Johnny Thomas, and qualifying looks to be wrapping up here. Not very many cars left on track, if any.
No, sir. I think we have Dell Owen. He's racing tonight, but hasn't qualified, and, of course, David Everly showing there, and the result is our race official. So it looks like Richard Garcia, yep, is now confirmed, takes the pole with a 28.647. Not too far behind in second place is Wade Lear with a 28.6. .653, and rounding off the podium, a common top qualifier, but not always a top finisher, Jess Story with a 28.681. So hopefully he can string together a whole race and maybe get a little bit better result, because, you know, qualifying well, that didn't get you anywhere in the points.
Just trying to wait until scoring rounds up over here. But we'll try and take you through the field here. Starting first, as we noted, will be Richard Garcia. He'll take the pole tonight. And then Wade Lear will be second. To be Jess Story will be starting third, Johnny Thomas fourth, as we noted, and I don't believe fifth is graded up yet. Again, we apologize for this. Our scoring is a little messed up at the moment, usually is at the beginning of races.
All good, worry about it later. You know, I really didn't see. You know, normally you can really gauge how the race is going to be off of off of practice, but sometimes you can't, because, you know, if you know, last week in the Cup Series of Bristol, everybody was wrecking, but for the most part we had a really clean race. And I mean, here it looks like practice was very tame, but who knows what it could lead to. We've got a good group of guys. We've seen them do it. I know they can do it. I know sometimes we get a little bit in over our heads, but I'm hoping for a good race tonight. I think our scoring should be up to date here soon, as we are 1 degree and moving.
So we're just a little bit off still. Not sure why that is. It was good a minute ago, so but they will be taking one pace lap here, and then we'll be going green. Golden Pace car up there. We'll lead them around set once, then they'll duck down pit road, and then we'll be getting going for 120 laps.
Bit of an older model there that has the field.
Yes.
Better keep that thing away from any crowds of people. Oh, sorry to any Mustangers out there.
Pace car will be pulling down pit road, and we are green. Richard Garcia on the throttle, and here we go. Nice jump, I may add. He'll easily clear everyone going into one. Jess Story looks to be taking over second.
I only have a car blinking. I'm not sure if you catch that. The 54 car seems to be all over the place. That might just be on my side. Looks like Richard Garcia's got a pretty good lead going into three here.
The 54, I believe, is having issues all through practice, so seems to be a bit stable now, but it might be an issue here.
Keep an eye on him. Hopefully that didn't cause any problems.
Jess Story all over the back bumper of that 57 car, looking for the lead here.
So much for pulling away. Jess Story is there.
Going to be door-to-door down the back straightaway. I believe he may have it going into three.
Let's see. I really don't know the preferred group tonight, but it looks to be the bottom. It's Jess Story coming off of four here. He's not quite clear, and he clears Jess Story to the lead. Richard Garcia second, and Wade Lear in the 07, not the 7. Third place. I'd be really interested to see, you know, something I'll be watching personally is, can Jess Story piece together a whole race? I'd like to see him get some good finishes, because I know he's got it in, and we just got to make sure you got to put the whole 120 laps together.
Yes, sir. And tomorrow night's race is going to be even longer, which I believe would be 200 laps, if I'm not mistaken.
You know what? I couldn't tell you. I'm a terrible league participant.
That's right, man. We always forgive you around here. Johnny Thomas is going to take third away from Wade Lear. And the 54 looked to make it. I thought he was going to throw it in there, but not enough room. I think with the blinking in and out, it looks like he has some damage, but it ultimately fixes itself once he pops back in.
hope all the Mustangers can forgive me for my comment earlier. I couldn't help. It seems to be on my screen, Sam was actually inside of the 54. Sam's on the apron. Seems to be okay. Doesn't have any damage. That's going to be a problem. Hopefully the race officials are paying attention to that.
Yeah, I'm assuming, if anything, they've already given him a warning.
Actually, he has been black flagged and said he checked his parking car. So, sucks for him, but thankfully it's not going to ruin anybody's night. I hate to see somebody's night be ruined by somebody with a connection issue.
We have the first car done for the night, and that would be the 54 out of a connection issue.
Brandon Short, is he a full-timer in this series, or that's not a familiar name to me?
I don't believe so. I think this may be his first run here in the B-Car series. I could be mistaken, but I have not seen that name.
Too bad for it to be cut short, but like I said, I'd much rather somebody park in the room, somebody's race over connection issues, so that's too bad. I'm sure we'll see. I mean, he obviously qualified well. Hopefully he can get that fixed and show he's got.
Got a pretty good battle going on here for the, really around the 10th position here. A close battle between Richard Hines, Rusty Webb, and Eddie Young.
Oh, the one car's ball off the infield. Will he make it back all right? Seems to be okay. That's Percy Martin up into the wall. Almost came across the spy of Sam Close's nose. Seems to got that thing back on the track. I think he lost two positions there. I don't see any serious damage.
Yeah, there's no major damage there. Just a little kink in the right side there, so.
I think
a little pit stop
away.
And it should be all good.
Got away lucky with that one. Thankfully, there's no drama there. We are 9 laps now clean. Looks like the race is very good. I'm glad to see this.
Indeed. Again, this battle is really heating up. Is Michael Skinner looking for that 10th spot? Looks like he's probably going to have the preferred line going into 3 here. No, Rusty's doing a pretty good job holding him off on the high side. That's actually pretty surprising.
Yeah, I thought, you know, whenever Jeff Story took the lead at the beginning that the bottom's going to be the preferred lane, either Mike drove in too hard or we have a multi-crew track right now. Raced too hard, and Richard Hines is right there too. He can capitalize on 2 spots potentially.
We got a pretty good battle going on behind them with Nathan Young and Richard Hines. Again, let's see. Oh, that top line is going to prevail yet again with Richard Hines pulling a gap on the 21. So that's pretty interesting. I think this may be the first time here at Charlotte that I've seen that top line prevail here on iRacing, that is.
Yeah, definitely for a fixed setup. I know I've seen open races, it works pretty well. I mean, Richard's on the wall. Well, yeah, Richard's on the wall that time. I think a little bit too high. I'm going to lose that spot right there to the 21 of Nathan Young. Maybe a little overzealous, but I'm pretty sure you can probably make that mid to high lane work for sure, without a doubt. I think the 18 of Paul Ross just got into the wall. No, he didn't. He had a lot of wheeling, so he lost a lot of momentum. He's going to lose a spot there to the one car, who also got into the wall earlier. So clearly the one car's damage is not too severe, but still making moves on the track.
Looks like the battle for the lead is going to heat up just a bit. Richard Garcia has closed the gap here on Jeff Story. Come down to 2/10 of a second separating the two. You can really see they've, at least Jess, he's moved up a groove. So obviously that top, or that at least the middle of the top line, looks like it may be the way to go here tonight.
Yeah, I'm really conflicted because, you know, Johnny said he was battling a tight car. Carlos said has gotten a little bit loose at the end of the run, so I'm not really sure. I mean, of course, you know, with the new tire model, I mean, you know, tires actually wear now. So if you're going to push it to the limit, which a lot of drivers haven't really adapted away from, you're going to get a tight race car no matter what you do. I mean, Jeff Story is, I mean, that's a high line right there. That's not mid. I mean, he's in the high groove right now. Richard Garcia is right behind him. It might be working for him. You see, he gets a good run down the backstretch.
It looked like he was going to put the nose in there going out of 2, or coming out of 2.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
gonna get the
I
nose this time. It's not gonna stick.
Though. Yeah, I think Richard Garcia is probably racing a little bit of a smarter race. I think does Jess have some damage on the right rear? Yeah. Oh yeah, he has side damage. Did we miss that, or is that happening while we're watching something else?
I think one time I may have seen him pop the ball coming out of, I believe it was probably turn four on a front stretch. So
yeah, I'm here on lap 14 looking at his replay. It's fine. I'm really confused. He might have been having some connection issues because on lap 14, in the that might just be on my screen.
I think that might just be on yours because I don't see any on my end.
All right, sweet. So if there's any damage, I'll just watch for your call because I think I might update itself later. My apologies.
Just right on board here with Richard Garcia. Could already hear him in the middle of 3 and 4 kind of pedaling the throttle, so it sounds like these tires may be going away here.
Yeah, it looks like he pulled in just a little bit and might have burnt his tires up just a little bit himself. We'll see.
1 and 2 are really a flat out kind of corner. When you get out of the gas, you can kind of get into it real quick. 3 and 4 is more of a tricky corner, so. But you can hear him trying to work it even more. Well, he's going to be side by side with him.
Yes, Jess Story's damage has reversed for me. My apologies. I actually have the same router Jesus Christ used to own.
Wow.
Impressive, I know.
I'm not quite sure I knew there was a internet back then, but the more you know here.
Yeah, he is actually a Comcast customer. Good guy. That was a good artifact, not so much wireless internet provider.
So the battle for the lead looks like it has calmed down just a bit, but I think we might have a battling developing here for the 8th spot with Johnny Thomas and Carlos Acosta. Carlos has the spot. And Johnny may... we got a 3-car battle here, actually. I'm telling you, Mike Skinner has just been on a roll here tonight. I don't think he qualified too well, so... Probably had to fight his way back up. He's actually going to get
The last lap of the first lap, do not differentiate to Mike Skinner. I mean, he's going all out all the time, which sometimes is a great strategy, sometimes it bites him, but I think tonight's really doing him some good. He's really moving up the track very quickly. I'd like to see where he ends up with it tonight.
Oh! Ever so close between him and Johnny, but it looks like they're going to be... They'll come out of that cleanly. Somehow.
Johnny Thomas, our defending series champion and our in-race reporter, running 10th right now, battling with Rusty Webb. Rusty's still up there making a hot... Well, it looks like Johnny's actually coming in here.
Battle for the lead. Sorry, race.
High side work.
Richard's going to throw it down into turn one for the lead. Not quite sure it's going to stick, though.
No, I think... I think the hot line's where you want to be. I think you just can't really get that car... where you want it. Even if you do get the nose in there, you can't really push out like you prefer.
Well, now he's adjusted his line.
On that. Maybe start out low, go high. That's pretty neat. Maybe something to carry over to our race.
Yeah, it's kind of cool to actually see a multi-groove racetrack developing here on iRacing. Their dynamic track had tried to adjust that, but no one had really dared to try it. So we've completed 22 laps here. We're on lap 23, and again, the pits, about the fuel window, is around 25 to 30 laps. So we should be seeing some drivers come in here. I've been told it's more around the 28 lap mark, so about 3 laps, should be seeing some cars hop on in. Richard just trying to get the nose underneath the 7 car, but he said the power out of 2. You can see Samuel Close in 3rd, about 2 seconds back. Nick Miller behind him, 3.5 seconds back. and Wade Lear 4.4 seconds back. So
kind of weird, you know. Normally we see Sam. I mean, he's in third place. Don't get me wrong, but I mean the leaders have a big gap on him. You know, normally we always see Sam battling for the lead, especially when he qualifies up front. But
oh, here we go.
Uh-oh.
Oh, so Jess is actually going to pit.
Jess Story's.
Whoa.
So is Sam close?
Real bad connection issues right now for Jess Story. He's gone. At least for me.
Yes, I'm thinking the same. I saw the same thing. I didn't want to say anything based off. He's back for me now. Hopefully that doesn't play into anything. He's having a good run. That would really suck to lag out of first place.
He's back. Whoa. Very, very bad connection issues right now for the leader. For the guy who came down as a leader. And Richard Garcia is not going to come down. Not sure if Jeff's story is returned yet. No, he hasn't, so.
Yeah, I'm on Jess's camera now, and it's just he's not there, so that's a real bummer.
Now, I think Samuel Close may come out as the leader of this. I believe he may have pitted about a lap earlier from what I just saw. So I think he may claim the lead here.
Okay. Jess, well, he popped back on my screen there for just a moment, so he hasn't throughput yet. But, I mean, it definitely looks like he's going to me. He's everywhere. I'm not even going to bother watching him. I guess we'll just watch the throughput message. There's no way. I doubt he's back on the lead lap right now because, you know, if he lagged so bad. Yeah, it shows Jeff Story is one lap down. So he must have lagged so bad it didn't count a lap, which is a real shame. Because Sam Close, let's see. I mean, Sam Close is shown on the lead lap in the sixth position. So that is a shame. To go from the lead to now one lap down, what a bummer.
One way to look at internet issues here is maybe car troubles here on iRacing. So, tough break, and Kim Quick, who, yes, is a guy, so he's going to pull it down pit road here. And we'll reclaim, or Johnny Thomas will now claim the lead here. Trying to get under Matt Hackathorn. Who is one lap down. Here the Donald Bell is the last car on the lead lap in 22nd, so 22 cars left on the lead lap here tonight so far. We've been caution free for 30 laps. Well, 29 actually. So with this we're gonna take a quick break here and you won't miss anything as we go side by side. Lead is tightening up here in the three-wide racing B-Car series. Richard Garcia had reclaimed the lead, and Sam Close is in hot pursuit right now, about 0.2 off the lead.
Yeah, it turns out, I guess Jess, it was lagging so bad that it just didn't count a lap. He went a lap down, and then he lagged down again, and then he comes back, and he's on pit road. He got back on track and went back to lagging. Right now, the results show him, Jess Story is now 6 laps down. I can only assume he's parked it or he's lagging so bad, but not exactly 3. Yeah, now 7 laps down. Yeah, actually, I see him on pit road. Too bad. That's not Jess's fault. It happens. But see here now, Sam, as I mentioned him earlier, he is pulling in Richard Garcia for the first place position.
Losing just a bit here, but he is trying to use that middle line, as we've said, has been maybe the preferred line all night, or so far tonight. While we were away, we saw a pretty good battle, about a 5-car battle. That was for the 8th position. That's kind of settled down now. It's actually kind of developed into the 8th place battle as of right now, between Percy Martin, Wade Lear, Dale Owen, and Corey Lindsey. It's turned into a 4-car battle. That would be the best battle on track as of right now. So I thought Dale was going to make it 3 wide there.
Looks like our in-race reporter actually just got passed. He was 3rd place. Johnny Thomas just got passed by Paul Ross and the Nick Miller machine. 4th place is our in-race reporter, Johnny Thomas. And rounding out the top 5 is Mike Skinner and his M&M's machine. I knew it wasn't long before we saw Mike up there. Let's just hope he can piece together a whole race. Same thing for Paul Ross.
Yeah, tonight was the reveal night for the Nathan Young Designs car, the mystery head. And as you can see right now, it's been Nick Miller that's been the mystery head tonight. Kind of an interesting picture to be on the front of a car, but we've got 3 cars running that tonight. You got Nick Miller, and then, of course, Nathan Young. As we wait, there you go. And Corey Lindsey, all running the Nick Miller machine here tonight. So kind of an interesting gimmick that Nathan Young has put together with his designs company.
Yeah, I was actually supposed to run one, but I've decided to take up a life in commentating with my good friend Justin.
We're glad to have you here tonight. And if you didn't hear the news earlier this
week... 1 second, Justin. It looks like Patrick McCusker... what happened here? Patrick McCusker looks like he came off of turn 4. He didn't get the wall. He didn't get loose. He just drove it into the grass and then got loose, and then ramped it through the infield.
That's already happened.
Came back up on track and spun back down into the apron. Not really sure what that was all about. I'm not paying attention. The only thing I can see. I don't know. He could have been loose. Just really couldn't be able to tell. Just
well, let's see
what
here.
His car was doing.
Well, I think he tried to make a pass on the grass, and obviously that did. Whoa! Wow! Big air.
Should leave that to Dale Earnhardt.
Yeah. Some big air there. Let's take a view from on top of the roof here. And some big air here as he hops over. Wow. He's going to barely come back on track, and I guess he'll be okay. Well, he's down pit road now to attend to some damage, so tough break for him, but an interesting maneuver here tonight.
Yeah, that's not, I'm not going to put that one in my playbook. I'm going to leave that one to Patrick there. I was going to say hopefully the car isn't damaged too bad, but that was I got some serious air. I mean, this is Monster Jam. He'd be first place without a doubt, but unfortunately this is iRacing, and I'm going to say that car is probably pretty heavily damaged.
Suspension-wise, of course. Didn't get a good battle for the 6th place. Oh, Rusty Webb! There was a good battle for the 6th place. It was a 3-car battle, but Rusty got into the wall there just a little bit, and that'll make it a 2-car battle, really.
Bad. Rusty's been running a good race.
Not really. Dale's kind of pulled away from them, actually. So, got a battle here for the 3rd position. Nick Miller gonna get across the Nick Miller machine, actually, of Paul Ross. That must be pretty weird for Nick, looking in the rearview mirror and seeing his face on a hood of a car. That should be an interesting experience.
Beautiful face.
It is. It's got a pretty interesting
hat on
as well.
Have you seen that mustache? Damn.
I have, yeah. I'm sad we don't get Nick's, what was it, like, stash of the race or
Nick's
something?
Nick's thick race.
Yeah,
race,
there you go.
Nick's thick racing moment of the week. I have to bring that back, without a doubt.
Have to bring that back to the podcaster.
Speaking of the podcast,
let's segue into that.
If anybody's wondering where has it been, the week before last week, is that how you say that? 2 weeks ago, right? Yeah.
There you go.
We were going to have, you know, of course, our weekly podcast, and I just got caught up with some personal stuff. Nothing serious. Like, I'm all good, no problem. But I just didn't have the time to do it. And when I did have the time, it was just going to be way too late to upload it. Because, I mean, any time it gets uploaded late, I mean, there's no interest for it because we're beginning a new week. And then, of course, the next week, I've had finals. You know, I'm in school. I've had finals and stuff that I've had to take care of. But I finished that, so I pretty much have way too much free time on my hand while I look for a job. So I'll have an extended version of the podcast up on the 3Wide Racing YouTube channel this week. Of course, Justin will be joining us again. Could become a mainstay here, depending on how my colleague Levi's availability changes. But, yeah, sorry about that. And Nick's the racing moment of the week. Be watching out for that, because if I can get Nathan Young, he's real good for graphics. Make us a real good graphic. Oh, yeah, it's coming back.
And just a little other nugget, Full Throttle TV has recently signed a deal with the IRA League to do some Friday night action here. That first race will be June 3rd, so look for that. And again, it'll be me, or Race Clark and I, up in the booth. We'll be about an hour long, so don't forget to check that out. So back to the race. Richard Garcia currently has a 2 second lead, and then from Samuel Close. And behind Sam, Nick Miller is about 8 seconds back. So I would say Richard's got a pretty good lead going on here. And with that, we only have about 9 cars really left on the lead lap. Nathan Velez would be the last one on the lead. Well, kind of flipped around, actually. But we actually got a pretty good battle going on for the 6th spot.
Yeah, I see some cars coming off pit road right now. So we'll have a good idea of who's really in this after this cycle of crew. I know a few people are coming down really early. It's really interesting to see how that pans out. I don't feel like number crunching is way too late. Just we'll see how it pans out, aren't we, people?
Yeah. So that would explain the number of cars down a lot.
Looks like, so Jeff Story has officially disconnected. Brandon Short, the 54, who we saw blinking very early in the race, he's disconnected. And it seems Matt Hackathorn just got a throughput. Looks like he was having some connection issues. I don't think Matt was really up battling for position. It doesn't matter where you're at. It's unfortunate.
Oh, and we have a caution.
Disconnect. Oh, there it is.
It was Carlos Acosta. He stopped over, and I believe that'd be turn 3 or 4.
Oh, the one. The one got involved as well. I'm not really sure how. Maybe avoiding it. I don't know
what happened there. Let's take a look.
Carlos is still spinning. Just came to a rest. Oh, wow.
Oh, I think something happened maybe to the 19 there. Oh, yeah, I believe we had lost the one car there. Oh! Well, that was turn one, the one car. I think he may have gotten loose there.
Yeah, it looks like this wrecked Stenford, if you want to take a look at the replay. I mean, that's not Carlos's fault at all. Take a look at that.
We'll have to take a look from the tune machine here. Not sure what happened to him. Oh! He had gotten clips from someone. Let's just go a little bit farther back there.
I mean, I would hardly even consider that being taken 3-wide. I mean, Michael Skinner just, he dumped him.
Wow. I think Carlos may have been trying to get down to pit road, and,
That's very possible, too. So, you know,
I don't think there's anywhere for Mike Skinner to go.
Yeah, I think I take back that comment. It definitely does look like Carlos is trying to get to the bottom. I don't think Paul Ross is in the wrong. He's up there, high side running his line.
Let's take a look on board with the number 15 with all this.
I don't see anything in the chat about Carlos calling from pit road. Of course, I don't have the voice chat up. I'm not really sure what happened to the one car. That's
he didn't even lift. Michael didn't even lift getting by him. So.
Yeah. I think that, of course, I was listening to Paul, I'm not sure what happened to Percy Martin. He just wrecked on the front stretch.
Yeah, he
is. Completely separate of this incident.
I think he just got loose coming out of the trial or something like that. Something crazy.
So I don't have Carlos' voice chat. I don't know if he called for Pit or not. If Carlos didn't, then I really can't fault Mike Skinner. And, of course, if Carlos did, I can't fault Mike Skinner and fault Carlos as well. So I don't know.
Well, I believe they all just came down pit road, I think. I'll just see here. They'll come down this time. Oh, here they come. So it'll be Samuel Close leading them down here. As the man of the race, really. Who's on three cars is now leading the race. That would be Nick Miller. How about that?
Yeah, I see in the chat. Looks like Richard Garcia. I think he was actually involved in that because he's asking why Carlos didn't hold the brakes. Yeah, Richard Garcia was involved in that. If you want to take a look at his replay on lap 51, coming to 52. Oops. I mean Richard. Man, runs right into Carlos while Carlos is stopped on the track. 87 of Richard Hines. So both of our Richards involved in that.
I think that may be just a bit too far back, actually.
If you don't get a chance to look at that, I mean, it looks like, Carlos was stopped at the bottom of the track. Looked like he was holding his brake. I don't think he really intended on resetting. He says here in the chat he still had a car that could have been repairable.
Oh, wow.
I gotta be honest.
Look at the front end of that 57 car.
Yeah, I think it's junk.
A tough brake.
We're under caution. I gotta be honest with you. We're under caution. You're supposed to slow your car down. So I'm not going to fault Carlos at all. Especially, he's not obligated to reset. There's plenty of track open on both sides of him, especially under caution. So, I'd pin that one on Richard for sure. Because, Carlos said, he had a car that was repairable. So I'm assuming now you're going to take that thing down pit road if it's repairable, get back on track and not go any laps down. So I think Richard shouldn't have been going so quick, I don't know, maybe you have a different opinion on that, Justin. Just my opinion.
Well, not much you can do when you're wrecked. You're just kind of hoping that no one else hits you. But with all that, we're on one to go, and the pace car is about to pull back in. So Nick Miller will be your leader, and then Dale Owen, Samuel Close, Johnny Thomas, and Corey Lindsey will be your top five.
Yeah, too bad we didn't get a chance to speak with our in-race reporter. It seems like, we haven't had a chance, and the second we do, it's just... just a lot of stuff to analyze. We'll get a chance to speak with him, I'm sure. Nick Miller to the point. Glad to see that. He's had a year across all series of ups and downs. Seems like he always gets caught in something he really didn't cause. So we'll see how he runs. Dale Owen beside him. We saw how great he was at Iowa. I think he got caught in trouble. I don't quite remember. That was a while ago.
I think he may have been caught up in one of the later ones. I'm not too sure, though.
I might have early onset Alzheimer's. Apologize. Sam Close in third. I don't know how long that'll last. In-race supporter Johnny Thomas in fourth and Michael Skinner in fifth. Don't look to have too much damage after the contact with Carlos. Looks like there's maybe a crack in the hood on my side of things. But the right side damage looks fine.
Running on board with Johnny Thomas, as you can see, a pretty good battle here for the second position between Samuel Close and Dale Owen. Looks like Sam's going to get that position. Johnny might try and peek his nose in there. Fairly close to halfway. We're about three laps away from it, so it's been quite a quick race here. Only had one caution. With that, why don't we take a look at our race recap here. We've only had one caution for three caution laps. and so far we've had 6 lead changes here tonight. Take a look at the quick weather too. The skies tonight are looking pretty partly cloudy. The air temperature is about 81 degrees. Track temperature would be the same, and we've got 55% humidity here tonight.
Yeah, and while you were naming off those statistics, looks like Sam Close and Dale Owen, it looks like Johnny Thomas now are going to pass our leader, Nick Miller. Did he come in for tires?
I don't believe so. I believe he stayed out. So I guess he was hoping for a quickie caution here. But
yeah, I mean, he was in the top 5 or 10. I don't think that might have been a little bit too aggressive of a move, but, you know, we'll see. I could say, you know, we're not the drivers, but we do race every week, so I guess we have a little bit more of a forward opinion.
Kinda, yeah. Just a quick update, by the way. We only have about 10 cars left on the lead lap, with Nathan Velez being the last car there. As you can see up front, the battle for the lead would be Dale Owen and Samuel Close. Really the best battle on track right now, so.
Yeah, I mean, first to fifth, I mean, well, pretty close. I'd say the gap between third, Johnny Thomas, and fourth, Nick Miller, and fifth, Michael Skinner, has lengthened up, but it looks like Dale Owen is right there. Really hasn't showed his cards yet, I don't think. We'll see. I don't think Johnny Thomas, from what I've seen, really has a car to get in front, but once again, we will see.
I'm really waiting, by the way, for Dale Owen to get back at what he lost at Rockingham, because he had been dominating that race, and a little pit road strategy kind of didn't go his way. So, looks like tonight may be a good night to rebound here. Looks like he's got a bit of right side damage there. Not sure if you mentioned that or not yet. That's maybe about the same as he had at Iowa. I don't think it'll affect him too much here. Not sure there'll be many cars here left tonight without some right side damage of hitting that wall. Probably off two, most likely. Boy, he's really breathing down the neck of Samuel Close here. Dale Owen is. Riding on board with him. He's really not letting him go, but he can't really make too much ground up either. Be interesting to see, maybe someone will move up a groove.
Yeah, I mean, maybe with him staying back there, he's conserving the tires a little bit. I mean, we'll see that later on in the run. I know Sam's pretty good at doing that as well. I mean, being a fixed setup, I mean, they could be just right on par with each other. It looks like Johnny Thomas is not losing too much ground. I mean, they're definitely inching away from him, which of course is going to show with the, course of a long run, which I think we will get with the way racing has been. Pretty spread out, a lot of give and not too much taking as it should be, which is great.
5 laps past halfway here. We're on lap 66 of 120 here. Yeah, again, Dale Owen just stalking Samuel Close right now. Not much of a gap, really. But here it is. Curious to see, should they get side by side, what Johnny Thomas will have to say about that.
Pretty tame so far. It does seem like Sam has gapped Dale Owen just a little bit, and of course they continue to inch away from Johnny Thomas. And it looks like Johnny Thomas inches away from Mike Skinner, and then we have a cluster of cars from 6th onto 9th. Justin also seems that I've been added to a group with all of my old high school friends. I don't want to talk to any of them, Justin.
Oh, sorry to hear that though, Chris.
rather talk to my online friends like you.
Well, thank you. I would say that online friends are more fun. But that's just
me. At least you guys aren't pregnant.
We won't even get into that story.
Yet.
Maybe that'll be for another
time. I like online friends. It's like I can turn them on and off whenever I want. And they can be terrible.
Whoa.
Super Mario 64 co-op partners.
Since little shots fired there, but
Pew pew. Looks like Sam Close has really gapped Del Owen now. So much so that it looks like Johnny Thomas might get Del Owen for second place. I got a knack for picking out these interest reports.
By the way, we got a pretty good battle for the eighth spot here. At least there was. It was about a 5-car battle there. Looks like that's kind of settled out now. Really, that wasn't but 3 cars there that were a lap down, so not much of a battle there. Looks like they just put one of the, that would be Corey Lindsay, they put one of the Nick Miller cars a lap down. Corey's actually going to go back at it. So I kind of presume that Corey probably just came off pit road, actually. With the way he's pulling away here.
Yeah, I'd say that sounds about right. Where is Corey? Corey is showing right now. He's at 89 tonight. All these new numbers in the B car series always throws me off. Corey is one lap down in 18th position. He's the furthest down of all cars, one lap down. So I wonder if he's playing a little bit of strategy here. I mean, as we stand right now, it's a two-stop race for anybody with about 25 laps. I mean, the only thing I can see Corey doing right now is short pitting, which could definitely work if we go green. I mean, as you can see how much quicker. I see somebody back there pitting as well. So it looks like we've had a lot of short pitters tonight, but I think with that caution kind of threw up the pit strategy and the fuel window and how it was going to work and how many stops until the end. So I know short pitting can really pay off in a green flag race, which really seems like what this is turning out to be. I mean, what happened between Carlos and Mike were really just, I mean, it's a, I wouldn't say freak accident, but it's not something that happens too often. So we will see. Just keep an eye. Remember Corey. Remember the 89 of Corey Lindsay. I'm not saying he finishes first, but I'd say if this short pit works out for him and he really, really pushes it, we could be seeing him maybe even top 5.
I think we may have some cars doing some pit stops here from what it looks like. Jeffrey Acri will be on pit road. The car you were mentioning before was Paul Ross. He started the brigade on pit road, that 18 Nick Miller machine. Oh, he missed his pit stop. Jeffrey Acri did. Donald Bell just now coming off of pit road. Wade Lear also on pit road. So, again, looks like green flag pit stops. That'll be, I believe, our third round here tonight. No, I believe our second, actually. As you can see, the leader, Samuel Close, will make his way down. Johnny Thomas and Dale Owen stay out as they now battle for the lead here. Johnny Thomas trying that high line. Let's see if he'll have the momentum coming off the corner.
Yes, sir. Our leader, Sam Close, as you can see, has made his way to the pits. Looks like we're at lap 76, so of course we still got 2 stops to go. I'm really excited to see how this one turns out. I'm really loving the green flag racing. There's always someone up front right there at the lead. Overall, good race. Charlotte always, it's not my type of track, but Charlotte always does seem to put on a good show.
So 44 laps to go. As you said, we'll have about 2 stops left here.
Dale Owen assumes the lead. But of course, he was right behind Sam. Oh. I see his mic queued up. I think him, yeah, it looks like him and Johnny Thomas.
Yep, they're now making their way down pit road.
First to second. Let's see who will inherit the lead. Be Paul Ross. Oh, no, excuse me. No, it will not be. Paul Ross is a lap down. You don't listen to anything I say.
I believe it'll be Nathan Young.
I think you're right. Everything's kind of confusing at the moment.
Nathan Young will...
More cars pulled down pit road here.
We'll take the lead here in the Nick Miller machine. So Nick Miller getting a lot of screen time here tonight. both in his car and on other cars.
I haven't really heard much from Matheum tonight. I mean, he's been around, you know, the bottom half of the top 10. I don't know if when it's a guaranteed two-stop race, if staying out as long as he is really going to benefit him, but, you know, maybe hoping for a caution. But once again, like, you know, this has been a very green race, so we'll see. I mean, he's driving the car tonight. I really don't know what he's feeling, so he knows more than I do. Let's see who's going.
Seemed to close. Has come back out on track and should take the lead here. Not quite sure what's happening with Dale Owen here. He might have stepped out of his car because it's not on track anymore. Race, do you see?
Who's that we're speaking of? I'm sorry?
Dale Owen. He's
Dale Owen, let's take a look.
He was second, and I don't believe his car's on track anymore.
Yeah, oh yeah, he's manually he's disconnected.
Wow.
You stay live. I'll take a look and see if I can figure out what happened.
Well, maybe he engine troubles. Maybe.
Okay. Well, looks like here he pits in his stall, no problems. Looks like Dale Owen on lap 77 pits in, no problem. He pulls out. Then he just stops on pit road. So it looks like, and the resets, it looks like something happening on the other side of the computer screen. Hopefully nothing too serious and everything's okay with this side, but it definitely looks like it was he locked up the brakes, reset, and disconnected, so hopefully everything's okay.
We've had some interesting stories coming out of here tonight, so. First, Richard Garcia, who was the leader, gets caught up in a wreck. And now Dale Owen, who was the leader, is manually disconnected. Two laps down so far, so...
Wow, so that changes a little bit of everything, doesn't it? Pretty much, as everything goes, kind of hands Sam a very commanding lead.
With Johnny Thomas.
I have Johnny Thomas behind a lap car here in second place.
2.3 seconds is the gap, so... With about 39 laps to go, we're going to take another break here, and then we'll take you to the end.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome back to round 6 of the Three Wide Racing Nathan Young Designs B Car Series here tonight. Not much has changed up front. Samuel Close now has a 6.5 second lead over Johnny Thomas in second. Wade Lear behind him. And, yeah, not much has changed. So, looks like it might be another dominating performance by Sam as, you see, Nathan Young, who was the leader before, is about to get put a lap down. So how quickly things can change around here.
Yeah, I think staying out for a while was probably a mistake in the long run. You know, we have a green track like this, and, you know, those guys are getting out on new tires and making a lot of time and while you're sitting there. Looks like Mike Skinner is going to go a lap down here.
Well, he might, but he's really trying. He's really fighting for it.
Oh, yeah. He can tell he doesn't want to, but I mean, just a few laps ago, battling for fourth and fifth, not that far behind Sam. I wonder if something happened there. It's really... I mean, he's on the lead lap, so he didn't get caught speeding or anything like that, so that's really curious. It's a shame. Doesn't have any damage? I don't know. Looks like Sam, I mean, he's definitely fighting for it. He doesn't want to lose it.
They got so close there coming off of turn four last lap. With 31 laps to go here tonight. So as we said before, there should be one more pit stop here. This should be coming. Whether that'll be under caution or under green. It'll probably be coming under green with how clean this race has been here tonight. So, if that's the case, we might see some pit road strategy here. Johnny Thomas, by the way, has fallen back to about 7 seconds. Wade Lear about 10.7.
Corey, it's funny, I just checked on Corey because, you know, he's been short pitting and he's pulling it in right now. This might be a bit early. I'm not sure, like, if he had to, but I'm not sure. I know we mentioned earlier that the fuel window is 25 to 30. We've had some drivers mention 27 to 28. So we'll see. Can Corey Lindsay pull off 30 laps?
I don't think. We'll see. Probably have to do some pretty good saving because, like we heard, the fuel window is about 20. I believe we were talking to Carlos. He said about 29.6, somewhere around that mark. So, be interesting. He just went 2 laps down. So, Corey driving the 89 tonight, filling in for Brent Miller. Couldn't make it to the track tonight. Not much changing around here. The best battle on track would probably be between Nick Miller and Wade Lear. It's not much of one. Well, it's starting to become one, I suppose. That's a battle for the third position as of right now. Wade looked to be mounting a charge to try and challenge Johnny Thomas up there in second, but so he'll fall into the clutches of the man of the night.
Yes, sir. I'd say if, we now only have 8 cars in the lead lap, of course. I know Corey's short pitted, so that's the only person I can see getting back on the lead lap here. Johnny Thomas is 7 seconds behind Samuel Close, so if this thing goes green all the way, I mean, this win has been pretty much handed to Sam, but we shall see.
Nick Miller, the man of the night, has moved into third position over Wade Lear. Rusty Webb would be fifth, about 15.5 seconds back. And 3.5 seconds back of Wade Lear. Samuel Close, the leader here tonight. That gap has grown to about 7.4 seconds over Johnny Thomas. Who, as you can see, has moved up to the high side, actually. I think he's just trying to make a charge towards the lead, but... Oh, and he just scraped the wall just a little bit there, so a bit too high. As he's going to pull down pit road, actually.
Looks like Kim Quick's going to call the night. He's disconnected. 14 laps down when he did so. And most likely finish in the 18th position.
Well, Race, I think we have our first bit of pit road strategy here coming up. Johnny Thomas has just brought it down pit road with 24 laps to go, so obviously he's going to try something here.
I think that's a really good call. I think that's a great call.
I think so,
he's
too.
He's only 7 seconds behind. He's only 7 seconds behind. And, of course, Sam doesn't look like he's pitting anytime soon. Well, we know for a fact you can do 20 laps, and 20 laps pretty confidently as well. So I think that's a smart call, especially, I mean, Sam's on the high side getting passed by lead lap cars. He's on the high side here in 3 and 4, so definitely not pitting this lap. I mean, let's see. Sam this time is going to click off a 30.868. Let's see what Johnny Thomas does in his quick lap.
Johnny Thomas just went a lap down, but should get that back when everything cycles out.
Oh, yeah, for sure. He does have some right front damage. Hope that doesn't really impair what he's been working on.
Just watching Michael Skinner there, coming into his pit stall, just about lost it. And, everyone's following him in. I guess everyone saw Johnny Thomas's theory, and they're all going to follow him in.
Looks like Sam Close stayed out another lap.
Interesting to see what. Oh wow, that 32 just slapped the wall there. Oh, and there's gonna be a wreck, Johnny Thomas!
No!
Oh my goodness!
Screw the strategy. Wow, that's. I mean, what? That sucks because he just weighed down a good lap. The engine is blown on that machine. What happened?
He's gonna get hit. Oh, and some anger. Some displeasure being shown towards the 43, and I can't say I blame him. That could have been avoided. Let's go back and take a look here. I kind of saw it developing, but wow.
I was watching Johnny Thomas from the nose camera, and all of a sudden just, what was that? I mean, that was just completely unnecessary. The 43 just went right to 32, I don't know why. But there goes Johnny Thomas' nine in any type of strategy to throw out the window.
Yep, Johnny Thomas just a unfortunate bystander in that.
Not too sure if it's a smart time to talk to him. Might be a little heated. But hey.
You can always try.
This is for entertainment.
Well, Johnny. We just saw what happened there. Obviously, that could have been.
Reporter here.
Obviously, yeah. That could have been avoided. And what did you see out there?
I don't know. I saw guys in the back not knowing what they're doing, but that's about it. I had a good car. I had a fast car. We were second. Sam was faster, car, but I don't know. It looks like somebody hit the wall, and then people 20 car lengths behind can't react fast enough when they have plenty of time to react, but. I don't know.
I also
We saw you short pit there. I'm not sure if you were short pitting, but I mean, you were you pitted well before Sam, and I mean Sam was of course slow on old tires, and we really thought that was a really smart move. And I was watching your nose cam to see what kind of laps you're running, and then all of a sudden that's really a shame.
Yeah, it's a bummer, but we were short pitting all day. I got all the way in the back there, 9th or 10th, and I short pitted that first run. And I got all the way up to, I think, first for a couple laps, and then I fell back to 5th. But I felt like that was the best strategy, and Sam started doing that too. But I wouldn't have caught Sam on that last cycle of pit stops, but I would have been certainly closer in case we would have had a late race caution. But I was the late race caution.
Oh, well, man, that's really a bummer. I was really excited to see how it was going to work, because it looked like Sam wasn't going to be pitting in any hurry. So you would have definitely made up a lot of ground on him. That's a shame. But, we'll hear from you tomorrow. And, of course, you'll be on the podcast on Monday. I'm sorry I said tomorrow. I forget today's. Today's Sunday. Man, I got all my days mixed up.
It's all right.
Whenever I'm with you guys, it's Monday. It's always Monday. And doing this broadcast is throwing me off. But that's a shame. Hopefully you can find a little redemption tomorrow. Because you've got a fast car. You're obviously pretty fast. Sorry about your luck there, Johnny. We'll talk to you here soon.
Yeah, take it easy. Thanks for broadcasting this race, and thanks for having me in the booth.
Thank you.
Hey, no problem, buddy. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
RIP.
Yeah. Unfortunate way to end here tonight. He probably could have had a good chance of winning there with the strategy he pulled, but obviously that kind of cut short on him. Again, that could have totally been avoided. I'm not sure what the 43 was doing there, but eight laps down, it kind of wasn't a good call. I'm assuming they had some sort of issue, him in the 32, earlier in that race. Have to be. Looking at the 32 here, the car in general was just kind of tore up in a mess.
Now,
43.
So this kind of changes everything, because of course, you know, this happened during green flag pits, so it looks like we have Sam Miklos, of course, in the lead. And coming to the green, it's one lap to go, so we'll come to the green at lap 105. We'll have 16 laps to go. Mike Stevens will be second.
Mike Stevens?
Yeah, we haven't heard from Mike. I didn't even know Mike Stevens was in this race. Actually, I did. I mean, I haven't really seen any of him at all. Look at his scheme. Have I seen the car? Anyways, yeah, I haven't seen Mike Stevens at all. Third place is Nathan Velez, and fourth place is Nick Miller, who we've seen half speed. Of course, he dropped like a rock earlier, but of course that was to him staying out, not to a lack of skill. So really, really excited to see what he can do. We're coming to the green here. Let's see. Sam likes to jump it normally. Let's see if he continues that trend here. Yes, sir. Oh, wait. Yeah. Yes, sir. Sorry, I'm not using B cars. A cars get speed just a little bit quicker. So Sam Close takes right off. Mike Stevens did not get a good restart. Nathan Velez will take second place. A little bit of rear-end damage. It just looks like a scrape. Shouldn't affect anything. Matt Hackathorne actually got around Nick Miller. Where is Nick Miller? Steven Kettman shows he's a lap-down car. And Nick is way back. Must have had a bad restart. Or somebody in front of him did not restart very well. Steven Kettman, who was not a part of this race at all.
Yeah, where did he come from?
Yeah, I mean, he's a lap down.
Two laps down, and he's flying. See back there, the two Nick Miller cars are fighting for a position. That'd be the eighth spot. And just in front of them is the man of the night. This is kind of a cool shot. Two of them together, and then you got Nick. Whoa. Mike Stevens looks like he got shuffled up just a bit there. Not sure if the 46 got in the back of him at all. What a crazy battle we got going on here right now. It's about seven cars under a blanket right there. And I'm sure Samuel Close right now is loving this.
Yeah, I mean Nathan Velez, he's up there, but of course you can see.
Oh,
Sam is pulling
right away. Michael Skinner just about lost it as he bounced off the 46 there. Mm. Look at this, Paul Ross trying to make it three
He's
wide.
Still right there. Nick Miller assumes the third place position. Mike Skinner is. I mean, look at them. They're two wide, three, four rows deep back there. This is not Talladega.
Yeah, they're lining
amazing.
Up like it is, Dega.
It's like Mike Skinner's going to take third. Mike Skinner up to third, Nick Miller fourth, and Paul Ross. Look at the Nick Miller and the two Nick Miller cars, 1, 2, 3 right here.
Looks like that's kind of settled down there, and unfortunate is Mike Stevens. He got caught up in the bad end of that. He's going to lose a bunch of positions. Once scoring catches up here, they come around. So not much of a battle going on right now between Nathan Velez and Samuel Close.
I don't know. Did Nick stay out again? Because Paul Ross went right around him. He's going to lose another position right here to the 07 car. I'm not sure if Wade Lear is on the lead lap here.
Yep. Oh, there goes the 21.
Oh.
Right up into Michael Stevens. Oh, boy.
Man,
but
right
10
there.
Laps to go.
That changes a little bit of everything, doesn't it?
Sir. I believe he got turned, but we'll take a look at the replay here.
I think you're going to watch. I want to watch Mike Skinner when we get back to green here. Let's take a look at this replay.
Oh. Skylar Nissel. Not sure what happened there. But let's take a look here. Watching Skylar here. Oh, and Nathan just kind of pulled right up in front of him. Or pulled down out in front of him. Another view I want to watch is Mike Skinner.
Oh, yeah. Nathan came right across Skylar's nose.
Watching on board the 63 machine. And, just the wrong place, the wrong time, and immediately that car goes silent.
Not much you're going to do about that.
So you said you wanted to watch Michael Skinner on this restart, and I kind of do, too. The way he's been driving tonight, he's ready to win.
Oh, yeah, I mean, he was on fire. I think... Nick stayed out, but he got around two other cars after slamming into one. I mean, the speed is there, so we'll see if he can execute properly. We'll see how much of a factor Nathan Velez is.
So I don't believe they've pitted yet. Will they? Is the big question. I know last year. That's kind of what it came down to, someone pitting and the leader not. Good caution. You saw the 46 pull down. He's 22 laps off the pace. The 31 will follow him, getting his lap down. See a pretty good number of cars come down.
I think it'd be a good time to speak to Mike Skinner. What do you think?
Sure, let's do it.
Where is that silver-tongued devil? Is
by be behind all the lap cars now.
Hey, Michael, sorry to pull you from your conversation. You got a copy?
Yes, sir.
You're looking pretty quick, and now you've got a golden opportunity. You plan on capitalizing or what?
Well, we're gonna see. Unfortunately, I think I'm gonna line up behind all the lap cars or all the cars that got the waiver round. So, unless there's mayhem, it's gonna be difficult. But I do have, I think, 5 or 6 lap fresher tires, so. We'll see.
I mean, did you get an EOL or what happened?
Well, no, I got the lucky dog, so.
You were a lap down. I didn't even notice that, man.
You were racing so good, we couldn't even tell.
Yeah, I was telling Justin to watch him ride because how fast he is.
It is fast. I do have to admit that. It's a hot ride, so we'll see. We'll see what happens here.
Well, all go right, out man. There and melt the M&Ms off it, man. Good luck.
Yeah, man, records are checkers, right?
That's kind of what it comes down to nowadays.
Wow, I didn't even notice he was lap down. I was too excited with how he raced.
It's pretty interesting. Well, see some damage on the back of the 48 car there. The lights are off on the back of or on the top.
It's only 1 degree, so. But I guess I don't know. It looks like Nick Miller has to go hold tires. I don't know what's going on. I mean, so I guess Nathan Velez is definitely one to watch.
Well, I mean, we're going to get going with 6 laps to go here. Not taking tires. I don't think that's too bad of a strategy. The leaders did not pit, however. So, there's Michael Skinner right there.
Yeah. That's a pretty good deal.
Sitting fifth right now.
Yeah. Thank you for him. Everybody's taking the wave around and everybody's lap down. So that works out pretty nicely.
Well, I'd say buckle up, folks, because I think it might be just a little bit wild here. 6 laps to go. Remember, we do not do green and white racing, so should we get the green flag and there's only 1 lap to go, we will not be going. The race will be official, so I believe, should we get a caution here quickly, might not be over, but anything past that, it'll be over. And here we go. Seemed close with a quick jump.
Yes, sir, same with the trademark quick jump. Keep an eye on Mike.
Michael Skinner up to 4th so far. Excuse me, 5th. Looks like Nathan Velez has some connection issues going on right here. be really interesting to see if Nick has anything for close here.
Yeah, Sam isn't necessarily driving away from him. Looks like
he's kind of he's closing in, actually.
And Mike had the nose on the 89, and I mean, Corey cut him right off.
Oh,
got into Corey right there.
I don't think he's too happy about that move.
That's all right. That's racing. We're late in the race now. That's fine.
Man, Nick is there. Everybody's there, actually.
Yeah, he's not really pulling away to see if Nick can race a smart racer and get up to him.
He's got four laps to do it.
See, Mike Skinner's going to try the high side. Oh, man. Oh, Corey Lindsey caught the apron just a little bit, so Mike Skinner will be able to clear him here. I'll tell you one thing. With four laps to go, coming on three laps, we'll see what Mike's got.
Race, we're about to have a battle for the lead here.
Let's see. Oh, yeah. Nick has made it up to him. I was afraid Nick was going to lose him.
He's right on the back bumper of that five car. Three laps to go. He's going to take it into the grass. That's kind of going to hurt his momentum here.
Yeah, Mike Skinner is loving this, I'm sure. Look at the run. I'm keeping an eye on Mike Skinner. You watch that lead. I'm really excited to see what happens here.
Coming down to two laps to go. It is go time here.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Look at him inching in. Oh, yeah. Mike Skinner.
Here comes the run. Side by side for the lead, two laps to go. Nick Miller, the man of the night, looking to take the lead. And
Nick
he
Miller?
Will clear him.
Oh,
how about that? But Sam's not over. It's not over yet.
Oh, yeah. Oh, what is Mike going to do here?
Boy. White flag coming up. It's going to be a three-car battle for the win here.
Oh, what is going to happen here? Three-car battle for first place.
Here we go, white flag coming out. One lap to go, race is official. Side by side for the race lead. And it looks like Nick might clear, no.
Oh yeah, Mike's
the momentum on
here.
The high side.
Oh, he's gonna take it three wide.
He's gonna take it three wide.
Oh, Nick blocks
gonna
him.
Keep walking.
Nick blocks, oh, I think that might be the move of the race.
The Nick thick move of the race.
Yes.
He's gonna clear him. Nick Miller, an amazing run, gonna take the win from Samuel Close. What a race.
That's impressive. That's very impressive.
The man of the night with his head on three cars. He's gonna take the win here tonight. And he's gonna take it away from the man who dominated most of the tonight.
I'm glad they finished that cleanly. I know Mike Skinner probably could have forced the issue a little bit more if he wanted to, but I'm glad to see he did. I think Mike Skinner needs some points anyways. But good for him. Good for Sam. Man, that was great. That was great.
Well.
Like, not even from a commentating perspective, from like a fan.
I think we had some. Hold on here. I think we may add some. Issues here. Not sure what happened to Nathan Velez. I saw him sitting on the front stretch.
I'd say we pulled Nick in here, man, because that was impressive.
I think he was, we're going to take a quick break before we get to the race winner.
Yes,
he looked like he was chasing down Corey Lindsey, but with that, we're going to take a quick break and we'll come right back for post-race interviews. What a race we saw here tonight. Welcome back to round six of the three-wide racing Nathan Young Designs B-Car Series. It is complete, and now we're going to take you through the running order here. So, of course, your winner, the Nick Thick move of the race here. He's going to take the win here. Samuel Close is going to come home second. Michael Skinner third. Corey Lindsay fourth. And Nathan Velez fifth.
Yes, sir. And rounding up the top ten is Wade Lear in sixth. You know, he was... You know, didn't really see much of Wade tonight, but he got a good finish. Sixth place. Seventh is Rusty Webb. Another good night for him. He got the wall that one time, but glad to see him finishing on the lead lap in seventh position. One lap down, Donald Bellick, another sleeper. Just, you know, you don't really see much from him the whole race. And there he is, eighth place, good points today. One lap down, Paul Ross, ninth place. Skyler Nissel rounds up the top ten, one lap down.
Finishing 11th would be Nathan Young. 12th would be Stephen Cruz. 13th, Stephen Kettman. 14th, Jeffrey Ackery. And 15th, Mike Stevens.
Yes, sir. 16th goes to Patrick McCusker. 17th to our in-race reporter and hopeful winner, unfortunately got involved in an accident, Johnny Thomas. 18th goes to Matt Hackathorn. 19th to Kim Quick. And 20th to another lead competitor, led a bunch of laps, Dale Owen. Not really sure what happened to him. Hope everything's okay.
21st is going to be Percy Martin. Richard Hines going to be 26th. Richard Garcia, 23rd. Carlos Acosta, 24th. And Jess Story, 25th. Not a good night for the Arcade Motorsports cars.
Yes, sir. And Cody Tabor and Brandon Short round out 26th and 27th. They finished 115 laps down. We know Brandon Short had connection issues. Not sure what happened to Cody. I mean, he obviously ran five laps, so I do not know.
All right. Well, with that, we're going to talk to the man of the night. He was on, his face was on three cars here tonight, and he pulls the Nick Thick move of the race. He's going to take the win here tonight. Nick, talk us through that final restart, man. How did you pull ahead of Samuel Close, and how did you get that win, man?
That was crazy, I'll tell you that. First of all, I had fresh tires, so that was a huge help. Sam was fast all night, so I don't think I could have got him without the fresh tires, but... And it just gave me enough to get into the corner and underneath them. I was still struggling to get off on exit. The car was pushing up, and I was trying to stay off them. But, man, Skinner got in there. He started mixing it up with us. And, man, it was just a battle to the finish. That was some white-knuckle racing there. That was a lot of fun.
And that was very, very exciting. Of course, as a commentator, I'm going to play up the moment, but I mean, I was like a really big fan of how y'all are racing right there. Nick, I tried to actually get you to be the in-race reporter when we started, and you said, don't talk to me unless, I forgot what exactly you said, but pretty much you didn't want to be the in-race reporter, but you have no choice not to talk to us. I mean, very, very impressive. I look forward to talking more in depth with you on the podcast. Good run. I mean, that was great. Finally get Sam out of the victory circle. Am I right?
Yeah, that's funny you bring that up, because you've been picking me. Of course, it was for the A car, but yeah, finally came through.
I know, right? Finally, help me out here. I'm really glad. That was great. That was a lot of fun to watch, and congrats on that for sure.
Thanks. That felt good. That was a good one. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Nick. Also, I was on the fence about bringing back the Nick's Thick Racing moment of the week, but after that, I mean, I'm pretty much left with no choice.
Yeah, it was kind of all around my night. I had a couple of guys running my face on their hood.
Yeah.
I come away with the victory, so...
This has been an amazing night, man.
Coming up all Nick tonight, I guess.
So. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, thank you, Nick. Look forward to hearing from you on the podcast, and I'm sure we'll see you up here more often.
All right, thanks, guys.
All right, well, our second-place finisher, not for a lack of effort, but he led quite a lot tonight, Samuel Close. Just kind of talk us through that final restart. How did Nick get around you there?
You know, he did a great job. He worked on me, and I couldn't hold it down on the exit of four with the old tires, and I couldn't carry as much speed. So, you know, I was just happy. I had a chance to hold him off just by being able to keep him pinched down on the inside line and not be able to get the run off. But I didn't have anything for those tires, and plus Nick did an excellent job bringing that one home too.
Yeah, you know, I was going to say, finally, you're not going to win the podcast, but I forget that I'm doing extended ones since I missed 2 weeks, so we'll see if you're Iowa win. But, I mean, of course, as always, a great run for you, Sam. Pretty much any time, not even in the B car, any time we're on something with four wheels, I mean, you're most likely going to be up there competing for the win. So, real good job to you. You guys put on a good show, a lot of great racing, and look forward to seeing what you'll do in Kansas. I'm sure you'll win it. Good race, Sam.
Appreciate it, guys. Yeah, that was a really good time. I had a lot of fun.
Quick question, Sam. Since it was Nick Miller, the winner of the race tonight, and he had three cars, or his face on three cars, how weird was that to see? From the booth, it was pretty strange, and the fact that he won just made it even better.
I don't know, but I think maybe he should try to get his face on the cars every week. Maybe that's
seems to work.
Charm.
Yeah,
you couldn't really see it on the hood from inside the car, but I did go look at it in practice. It was pretty funny.
All right, Sam. Well, good run here tonight, and good luck tomorrow. Here should even be even better here.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for the broadcast. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right, well, our third place finisher here tonight kind of tried to make it interesting there, that final restart. Michael, just kind of talk your way through it, because you restarted fifth and somehow got around it to almost winning the race here.
Yeah, getting a lucky dog there actually ended up helping me, and for whatever reason, it actually moved me past all the wave-around cars, because I guess Sam and Velez ended up staying out, because I thought like Sam and Velez like go through the grass, so I guess it counted them as staying out, and they actually didn't get the wave around, so they were still technically one lap down. So that was 100% luck on that, and from there on it was just flat out just do whatever I could. Their teammate Corey, he put a couple blocks on there to help his teammates get out just far enough to where I didn't have enough laps to actually do anything. But all in all, it was a good night, and I definitely needed the points. It's been a tough season in A and B, so we'll take this and move on to wherever we go next week.
Kansas. That was a really great race. I was, I told Justin to watch you on this restart, and I didn't, you know, I saw Corey kind of blocking you, and you kind of stayed behind him. I thought maybe you didn't have as much speed as I thought you did, but the second you went the high side, I mean, it really showed how quick you are. It was, and I applaud you, you know, for not coming there and just killing everybody. I mean, I'm sure one lap more, you probably would have had that. But that was a really impressive run by you. You put together, I mean, you know, I'm not going to lie. I say, you know, at the beginning of the race, I'd say if Michael could string together a full 120 laps, he's going to finish great no matter what. And you did. So good job on the third place finish. I'm sure more of those to come. You'll find Victory Circle here very soon.
Hopefully. It's just nice to actually finish where I've been running this season. And
sir.
Yeah, you can run in there and move them out of the way, but at the end of the day, it's more fun doing it this way and actually earning it, at, you know, when I get the chance to, rather than moving them out of the way. But it was, like I said,
yes,
it was fun, and hopefully it was a good broadcast. I know I had a lot of fun. At one point in time, I was two laps down to come back and be beaten on the back bumper of one and two. I'll take that any day of the week.
Yes, sir. Good race, and I'm sure, like I said, we'll see you up here in Victory Circle for long.
I hope so. I'll talk to you guys later and hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see both of you tomorrow night.
Yes, sir. Peace out, Girl Scout.
All right, and with that, as you heard, our next race here for the three-wide racing B-Car series will be Kansas, May the 29th here. And with that, we'd like to say thank you for watching here tonight. We hope you enjoyed that finish. What a nail-biter. So with that, for Race Clark, I'm Justin Cole. Thank you for watching here tonight, and we'll see you in Kansas.
Stay classy, San Diego.
Actually... Well,
oh.
I guess we'll release it now. For the three-wide racing series, not sure if you've seen the recent news about the South Boston race here coming up, I believe, next week. Me, Race, and Full Throttle TV will actually be covering that race. So it'll be our first A-Car series, and it'll be an all-star race, so it should be a pretty interesting race. So we hope to see you there. And with that, we'll say goodnight now. Again, for Race Clark, Justin Cole. Thanks for watching.
Stay classy, San Diego.